Hello and a very warm welcome to our SOCS video for using symbols in organizational development. Within the framework of organizational development, we now present the business model canvas. What is a business model? First, for whom? A business model identifies the customer. Second, what? The service or product that creates value. Third, how? How you create your product or your service. And it's about the money, about revenues and costs. A widely used tool is the business model canvas, developed by Alexander Osterwalder. This video shows how to work with the business model canvas using symbols. If you need more information about the basic tool itself, follow the link previewed in the video description. Counseling sessions on business model canvas with symbols. The following video describes the counseling process step by step.
Hello, Leonie.
Hello, it's nice to be here.
Yeah, great. So you're thinking about your own business. So what is your business idea?
I would like to have my own business as a dietitian.
Okay. And today we start thinking about how to go on with that.
Yeah.
That's great. So I think you know, whenever you start a business, two things are very important. The first thing, you need a client.
Okay.
That's the one you sell the product or you deliver the service.
Mm-hmm.
And for sure you have something. So you have to have service or a product.
Okay.
And now I would like you to think about very concrete features on the one hand of your service or product, and on the other hand to identify your client as clear as possible.
Okay.
So this means if you think about your client, your target group, think how you could approach him best. There are a lot of different channels to approach somebody. Maybe mm-hmm. you attract him on a cognitive level, so you reach him at the brain. There's always a heart, there's a kind of stomach, a feeling in the stomach. There's some hands, some feet. So there are different places. Please think of a person who could be interested, could be keen on your service.
Okay.
And also, please do the same thinking on your service or on your products. So what are the key features? What is the need you really can fulfill? What is your main benefit, your added value of your product or service? Okay, now I would like to ask you to choose some symbols,
mm-hmm.
always representing key features of your service.
Okay.
And also to describe how your client looks like or how you would like to approach it.
Okay. Fine.
So now I leave you alone with the symbols. I'm back in 5 minutes and then we go.
Well.
Okay.
Step 1. Talking about the value, your services or products, and to identify the customers.
Okay, Leonie, now I'm back again.
Yeah.
You already chosen your symbols.
Mm-hmm.
And as a next step, I would like to ask you to describe each symbol, mm-hmm. what it stands for.
Okay, so here is my service. So I would like to make counseling in dietitian. So mm-hmm. nutrition counseling, and there is the food, and this for babies. So I also would like to make some cooking classes and workshops.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And on this side, it's my client. So for the brain, the money, because I need clients with money. It's not mm-hmm. so cheap. And here the clients, I would like to work with parents and their children,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
and as well with people with adipositas. So they are too thick, or on the other hand, they are too thin, so with people with anorexia. And I think that's something between the heart and the stomach, So there are a lot of feelings and illnesses.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So, did you tell me everything?
I think so.
Okay, so that's great for now. I see you already have very clear ideas in mind.
Mm-hmm.
And now I really would like to go a little bit further.
Okay.
Deeper. So the first thing is on your services.
Mm-hmm.
The most important thing, if you deliver service, that you have to create a value for your customer.
Yeah.
And a value always means that something that the client is really interested in. There's a clear benefit for the client. So from your understanding, what do you think? Which value proposition are you able to deliver?
I think my best value is health.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
That's the most important for my clients.
Yeah. So you promise, if clients come to you, that you support their health.
Yeah.
Okay.
Absolutely.
In that case, I would like to ask you to choose a symbol that stands for this health.
Okay.
Promise.
I think this anchor, because our health is really, really important in our life.
And you also told me that you would like to work with adults, but also with kids. Do you think kids themselves are really interested so clearly in health? So do they already know it? Or is it more the parents you have to address?
I think it's more the parents, because I would like to work with younger children as well.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So in that case, you have the child as a direct beneficiary, as a client.
Yeah.
But it's the benefit you have to create for the parents. Which could be the benefit you create for the parents? It's maybe not, it's related with the health for sure, but why do they care for their kids? What they are seeking for?
I think it's important for them because that's their responsibility.
Yeah.
They have to do it.
I also think so. So maybe you contribute for taking responsibility for the kids.
Okay.
So this might be a very clear benefit that you are able to deliver.
Okay. Then.
So in that case, I would ask you to choose a symbol for this kind of responsibility.
Okay, I think this could show the responsibility from the parents.
Yeah. So now we added something. We added clear value for the customers.
Mm-hmm.
We added the health issue.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why people come to you. They are seeking for health. And on the other hand, you're supporting the taking responsibilities for kids.
Yeah.
This might be your clear value. Okay. So then let's talk about your clients, your customers.
Okay.
It's also very important to know your customer as good as possible.
Mm-hmm.
Because the more you know him, the better you can deliver service.
Yeah.
You better can customize your service. So the first question, and I think you know the term, is to identify segments.
Mm-hmm.
So it has to do with a clear target group. So which customer segments you would like to address?
I think one important point is the age.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So I would like to work with younger parents between 20 and 30.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And then with people between 40 and 50, because
mm-hmm.
there are more illnesses, the topic health is more important for them.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So I think these are two segments.
Yeah. So this is more or less the segments for the adults.
Mm-hmm.
Do you also have clear in mind kids who could be in need of your service?
Yeah, they would like to start with the mothers when they are pregnant,
mm-hmm.
so really, really small kids.
Yeah.
And then the first 4 or 5 years, mm-hmm. so with really mm-hmm. smaller kids.
Yeah, I totally agree, because as I know from my past, so in times when women are pregnant, so or also in times they are breastfeeding, nutrition becomes very, very important. So maybe that's important to have a clear focus on segments like this.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, do you need a symbol to remember this? Or?
I think it's like a present.
Mm-hmm. That's great. The next thing you have to think of is how to get in contact with your client, so how to deliver your service.
Mm-hmm.
This means you have to think about channels. What are the main channels you think you could use for your services?
I think most important is face-to-face,
mm-hmm.
so
mm-hmm.
in my office,
yeah.
or also a kitchen for my cooking classes.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Could you choose some symbols for them?
Mm-hmm.
That's great.
Okay.
So, as you already told me, so your one product is a cooking class or one service. There you need a kitchen, and for the counseling you need the office.
Yeah.
Do you see any other possibilities how to deliver your service? You know, in times of COVID-19, it's not so easy.
Yeah, that's true. So it would be great online.
Yeah,
have some workshops online.
Yeah, that could be another channel to your clients. You already...
Like in a nutshell,
yeah.
have to be in focus.
That's great. So you already did choose symbols before I asked you. That's great. So we are a good team to cooperate. And the final thing I would like to be interested in, so do you have any ideas how to build relations to your clients? As you know, it's not so easy that people, especially at the beginning, know that you have some services to offer. So how do you think it's possible for you to come into contact with your clients?
I think their website, so online, mm-hmm. is very important,
yeah.
but as well networking. So
mm-hmm.
I have a lot of colleagues. Additional colleagues or medical doctors.
Ah.
That's a point.
Uh-huh.
And as well, I think in my hometown it's easier because the people there know.
Yeah. Why you talked about medical doctors? Do you think they suffer more from adipositas or more from anorexia, or why they're important for you?
They are very important for me because I need like a sheet from them that's allowed to work with my
great.
Clients.
Yeah, yeah. So they are also, you use them as multiplier.
Yeah.
So you would like to use them to get their clients as well.
Yeah, that's absolutely correct.
That's a good idea. Choose some symbol for that. Yeah, that's great. So as you see, now we really discussed your value.
Mm-hmm.
That's what clients are interested in.
Okay.
We have a clear definition of that. And we know a lot more than before about how to approach our client and who does he look like, how does he look like.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that's great for now, and then we go to the next step.
Okay.
Step 2. How to produce the product or to deliver the service. Key resources, key activities and key partners.
Okay, Leonie, so now we already know whom you would like to sell your service. You know what you would like to deliver. And now we have to talk about how you will be able to deliver your service.
Okay.
And if you talk about how, it's always important not to think of each small single step, but always just focus on key resources, key activities, key partners.
Mm-hmm.
So just a very rough big picture of all the activities you have to do.
Mm-hmm.
And as I mentioned before, thinking of the how, so how you produce your service or your product, you have to think about which key resources do you need.
Okay.
I think you know the term resource, what could be. It could be an office, it could be a structure, it could be some important tools you need.
Yeah.
You also have to think about key activities.
Mm-hmm.
Key activities are the main steps you have to go through before you are able to deliver your service.
Mm-hmm.
So what are all the steps you have to prepare? You have to prepare yourself, or you have to produce to make a good product or deliver a good service. And the third question, because not everything in the world you can do for yourself.
Okay.
Maybe you need some key partners. Key partners could be useful for your network, but also could be some suppliers. Okay, so now you get 5 more minutes and you should just choose some symbols for key activities, key resources, and key partners.
Okay, fine.
Okay, I'll leave you alone again. So, okay, Leonie.
Hi again.
You've done a quick job. I think you will start your business quite soon.
Hopefully.
Yeah. Please tell me a little bit about your symbols you've chosen.
Okay, so I think my most important resources are, of course, the office and the kitchen. So I choose one house for everything. I would like to be in one building. And then the second one, the case, I think I need a lot of papers, sheets for my clients. There are a lot of scripts, work. Yeah, and then activities, and there's one symbol in the middle that stands for my website and all the promotion work like this. I think it's an activity because I have to do it, then it's also a resource because the website is something I have in the end. And then my partners are are the medical doctors. They are most important for my work. And then the second one, I would like to work as well with companies, with big companies, to work with their clients, with their customers.
So at the first point, it's quite a rough picture. So it's a good starting point to go a little bit more in depth on things you really, really need to run your business. So maybe we think a little bit on resources. We already thought about a kitchen and an office. You said you're also interested in deliver some online counseling.
Yeah.
So in that case, maybe you need a program.
Okay.
Do this, or maybe you need a customer relationship management program, so that you have all your contacts organized, the bookkeeping software. So maybe you add one or two different symbols, so for things you need additionally. So maybe one for software. I think that could be quite
okay.
Quite important.
One for software.
And what is the muscle stands for?
All the equipment I need.
Okay, that's great. That's great. Related to activities, you thought about a promotion. That's what you told me. As you would like to deliver your service online, are you already well educated on online tutoring, online counseling?
I think so.
Okay, so you're well prepared on that?
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you also have to prepare some stuff, some manuals, some training slides?
Yeah. That
could be a very important activity before you start to offer your service. So to prepare yourself, to prepare materials, isn't it?
That's true.
Yeah, maybe you choose a symbol for that. Yeah, what else could be important? So as you told me, you already thought on promotion via a website, but the word of mouth for personal contacts are important.
Yeah, that's very, very important.
So maybe it could be good to do some networking at the very beginning.
Yeah.
So meet all your friends, tell them about your idea, about your business. So maybe you choose one symbol for that activity. Yeah, what does this stand for?
That stands for like networking.
Great.
Or like a beginner multiplier event to tell the people, hey, I'm here, I would like to work with you.
That's good. Thinking about partners, you already thought on these medical doctors. That's what you explained me. That's a multiplier to get the clients.
Yeah, it's one of the most important.
And the yellow symbol, what that stands for? I forgot it.
That stands for companies I would like to work with.
Ah, great.
So because it's really difficult as a dietitian when you work with clients, they come one time, maximum 10 times, mm-hmm. and that's, mm-hmm. then it's over most yep. of the time. And if I could work with a company, mm-hmm. there I get more clients.
Yeah, that's good. You also told me you're interested to work with children, young children.
Yep.
Do you have any idea where they are during the day?
So in kindergarten?
Yeah, maybe it could be good also to network a little bit with kindergartens.
Okay.
Yeah? So you choose the symbol for kindergarten. And the question is, would you like to start your business for yourself or would you like to cooperate with some colleagues? You have also some colleagues who are interested to do more or less the same. Does it make sense for you to work in networks or would you like to go alone?
I would like to go alone. Great. I think it mm-hmm. makes sense to work really close yeah. with medical doctors, mm-hmm. but the work from dietitian are really similar.
Yeah.
So it's not so easy to work.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It's just important to think of mm-hmm. the different possibilities. But I see you are very clear, already decided, and that's great.
Step 3. About money, revenues, and costs.
Okay, and as you know, always we talk about business model, so it has to do with money. And this is now the final step. I would like to work a little bit, just as a rough idea. So whenever you talk about money, it has to do, on the one hand, with revenues, so where mm-hmm. comes the money from? Do you have any ideas how to get money from your clients? And on the other hand, it has to do with costs. So all the resources and also your time, there are some costs will occur.
Yeah.
So maybe you just think 1 or 2 minutes now on the main issues on costs and revenues.
Okay.
As it does not take too much time, I stay here now.
Okay,
yeah.
I'm ready.
Mm-hmm. So let's always stay positive, so start with revenues. So in your understanding, where does the money for your business come from?
The clock, the symbol stands for my counseling sessions
yep.
and workshops
mm-hmm.
and the car because it's a really flexible job. So I would also like to drive the companies when they need me.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
The heart is for the cooking classes.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I think they are very important because that's also a good thing for health people.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and then on the other side...
It's a little bit
okay.
too quick, so maybe let's go a little bit closer to the revenues. So
mm-hmm.
your idea is to make money on the one hand with counseling sessions.
Yeah.
On the other hand with kind of mobile service, where you really go to companies, bigger companies, and do some on-site
mm-hmm.
consulting. And the third thing were the cooking classes.
Yeah.
Yeah. So these are three different services you already thought of, and I would also like to think of how would you like to charge them. So on the one hand it's always possible so to charge for each single service,
mm-hmm.
but if you would like to get in deeper relations with your clients, maybe you could offer some ABO system.
Okay.
So maybe if they ask for 10 sessions, you offer them 12. That could be an idea.
Mm-hmm.
You already talked about revenues. Let's go a little bit more in depth. Your idea is to earn some money by your counseling sessions in your office, also with a kind of mobile service. Mm-hmm. So you come to the companies, you do some on-site counseling, and also to earn some money with your cooking class. These are three different services where money can come from. I also would like to ask you to think about how to charge them. Mm-hmm. So you can charge them for each single service. Mm-hmm. Do you know other ideas how to charge people or to get money from?
To make a stronger relation. It's like our system, okay, that they have to come again and again.
Yeah, yeah. So for a duration, maybe for half a year, for they example, say a fixed amount per month, mm-hmm, and then you offer them a specified service. I think mm-hmm that's good. In some cases, it's also good to have different offers. Let's say a bronze, a silver, and a gold AVO.
Okay.
With different services from your side. In many cases, people choose the AVO in the middle, mm-hmm, because they think that's worth best. So that could be an option. Also, if you sell more sessions in one time, yeah, so to offer them a discount.
It's also good.
Yeah. What could be the idea on that discount?
I think I would like to make it more like if you pay for 10 mm-hmm seasons, mm-hmm, lessons, you get the last one for free.
Great. So maybe you choose an offer so for these different possibilities. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You also talked about the online part.
Yeah.
Maybe you also need a pricing model for your online sessions.
That's true. Okay, so one symbol more.
Yeah, would be a good idea. So, because it's very important to have a very clear pricing list. Mm-hmm.
So that's easier for me because they're really clear in Austria.
Yeah, yeah, and it's also important for the clients because they're always afraid if they go to somebody who consults them that it's extremely expensive.
Yeah.
So if you're clear scheme, clear pricing list, you do a favor for yourself and for your clients. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Think about costs. Which costs did you take in mind already?
Yeah, the first of all, of course, my building, so mm-hmm, my office. Then this one stands for all the insurance, mm-hmm, mm-hmm, the things I have to pay.
Sure.
Then the heart stands for my own money, mm-hmm, and mm-hmm to live. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And the butterfly is all the money for the promotion, the website, mm-hmm, the software, like mm-hmm the digital things. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So I think for the moment it's fine. So because there's a lot of existing material, Excel sheets to plan.
Yeah.
So the important thing is now to have a big picture. Mm-hmm. The next step for you is now really to fill the canvas I already gave you.
Okay.
And to use this calculation Excel sheets to start with a first clear calculation on how much you have to sell to survive.
Okay.
Okay, Leonie, great work. So I'm quite sure that you will be successful.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Bye.
Goodbye.
Bye.
All the best for starting your own business. To find out more, please visit our website.